Focalini, the dance of Jesse Montgomery Strong, and the breathless thrill of Bella Bartok performed by Vienna, Fiona Walt, and Mark. 16 through 19.
Your home is a one-of-a-kind piece of art, a palette of design elements reflecting your personal aesthetic and functional needs. For over 20 years, All Natural Stone's exclusive collection of luxury tile, exotic and specially natural stone, and masterfully engineered porcelain has been transforming homes into pieces of livable art. Visit one of All Natural Stone's four Bay Area showrooms in Berkeley, Dublin, Birmingham, and Kansas City, or at allnaturalstone.com and find your inspiration. You can dine in art, entertain in art, bathe in art, laugh in art. You can live in art.
You can find
crash this week in the California desert. Captain John Sachs died when an Osprey Air Patrick, Bo Donegal, and Selena. The call from NBC, this is Fletcher's sixth victory at Belmont. This is CBS News.
Hiring is a lot easier with Indeed. Their powerful platform makes it easy to attract, interview, and hire candidates all in the same place. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
I'm Nora O'Donnell in the nation's capital.
The CBS Evening News with Nora O'Donnell. Bringing understanding.
Mr. President, there's a lot to talk about.
A lot to talk about.
With such first, it's a national emergency.
Unbiased reporting.
You think she was afraid to report what happened in Afghanistan?
Yes, ma'am.
What's your life on the line?
Why do you do it?
I just love being out there.
Making sense of our world.
Do you think there's something about the pandemic that unites us all?
The CBS Evening News with Nora O'Donnell. Weeknights on CBS.
Anti-Asian attacks sweep the nation.
It should always challenge every one of us. There's attacks on any of us.
More and coverage of the search for a missing white woman, but
there are dead people in the black and brown community.
I'm CBS News radio correspondent Dallas Keys, and this is The Kaleidoscope, a weekly podcast about systemic inequities across America. Conversations every Friday. Follow CBS News Radio's Kaleidoscope on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your podcasts.
A famous pop singer has revealed he has a rare disorder that has paralyzed half his face.
We're away from you, I'm with the stars.
Justin Bieber has posted on social media that he's suffering from Ramsey-Hunt syndrome, which affects nerves in the face through a shingles outbreak. Bieber says that's why he had to cancel shows in Toronto and Washington, D.C.
I'm just physically, obviously, not capable of doing them. Pretty serious.
The singer says he's unsure how long it will take him to heal. Jennifer Kuiper, CBS News.
Oklahoma's attorney general is seeking to move forward with the executions of 25 death row prisoners. John O'Connor asked the state's Court of Criminal Appeals to schedule the executions. His request comes after a federal judge in Oklahoma ruled the state's three-drug lethal injection won't create severe pain and suffering and is constitutional. Wendy Gillette, CBS News.
It's 5:05 at the Bay Area's news station, KCBS. Temperatures starting to cool off. A big cool down on the way tomorrow. Good afternoon. I'm Chris Ancarlo, and here's what's happening. Fire crews are currently battling a large debris fire that's sending up thick black smoke into the air above eastern Contra Costa County. CAL FIRE spokesman Dwight Good tells KCBS the fire broke out at a landfill near Kelso and Burns Roads. And at this time, it's still not clear how big or contained the fire is. Officials say at this point, no buildings are threatened and no brush has caught fire. Stay tuned to KCBS for updates as they come along to us. Students in San Francisco are demonstrating outside City Hall. KCBS's Jeffrey Schott reports the event is one of dozens taking place across the country to end gun violence.
The rally was organized by San Francisco high school students.
In this world, it can be easy to prioritize different things over others. But what we're here to say is ending gun violence should be a priority.
Supported by community leaders.
We have had this conversation so many times. Whether it be mass shootings, whether it be the killings that are happening in our inner cities on a consistent basis.
The rally and others like it across the nation were inspired by an organization called March for Our Lives, which has called for an end to gun violence since the deadly shootings at the Marjory Stoneman High School in Parkland, Florida in 2018. Cal Kenosha, a local high school senior who helped organize this rally, recalls that terrible day.
And that was the type of tragedy that it's almost like it's impossible for politicians to ignore it, at least that's what I thought at the time. But they did just that, they did ignore it. And so the fact that shooting after shooting, there's been multiple mass shootings since then, and we're still not getting any federal gun legislation, and even in response to the Uvalde shooting.
There were 96 incidents of gun violence on U.S. school campuses in 2022. 40 people have died, 78 injured. At San Francisco City Hall, Jeffrey Schau, KCBS.
When you think about public health crisis, you may not immediately think of racism, but as KCBS's Matt Bigler reports, that's exactly how the city of Oakland views discrimination based on race.
This week, the Oakland City Council unanimously passed a resolution
declaring racism a public health crisis.
City Attorney Barbara Parker says racism has very real
impact on public health. For example, other speakers pointed to the high number of African Americans who are homeless in Oakland.
Just because we're supposed to be progressive or whatever doesn't mean that we don't have a potential disenfranchisement of systemic racism that is embedded in our city.
City Councilmember Carol Fine says she wants the resolution to result in real changes. The city is setting aside $350,000 for data collection and consultants to find out more about the connection between racism and public health. Studies have shown that race-based stress can lead to everything from hypertension to inflammation and abnormal gene activity. In the East Bay, Matt Ziegler, KCBS.
Just ahead on KCBS.
I'm Michael Wall. Costs still rising. Now the president and the Fed will tackle easing inflation, now at its highest level in four decades.
Energy, right at the pump, and in food, and those are two areas where Putin's actions are really-